you went to a hilarious protest about Dave Chappelle holding up the "We like jokes, jokes are funny," and you got assaulted. Can you lay that whole shit out? Because it is wild.
Fucking asshole. I think that's why all my accounts just got canceled, too, is because I started posting the identity of the Antifa guy that attacked me. And everything got wiped right away. So, I mean, you guys, you like jokes, right?
Love well, don't it. Tell it's, us what his name was.
Yeah, no, I won't. I won't fuck up your stuff. You like jokes, everybody? Them, yes. Jokes are funny? Y'all agree?
Two thumbs up.
So, you know Vito Giswaldi? Has he come on this show?
No.
It sounds...
He's a 4Xer, I think. He's a 3XL or a 4XL.
Most Vitos are.
Yeah. He's a friend of mine. We do the Biggest Problem podcast together. We rebooted it. We're doing that every Friday. But he rings me up one night and says, hey, tomorrow there's a Dave Chappelle protest at Netflix. All the Alphabet people are coming out, and they're going to demonstrate how they don't get jokes. Mm-hmm. Alphabet people are LGBT, LGBTIA+, whatever. What do you see?
It's too many.
Alphabet is the Google about... thing, and I couldn't make it.
I thought of FBI.
We're not talking about stocks right now.
Thank you.
He says all the Alphabet people or the trans people are doing a little protest to demonstrate how they don't like jokes. And do you want to go hold signs at it? Because that's his deal, going to protests and being a jackass. Like, he did a thing where he brought a Pepsi to a riot and was trying to do that Kardashian commercial. You guys should have him on. He's really funny.
He sounds funny. We should get
him on. He's going to the cops and they're like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, Antifa's behind him throwing bottles. We went to the LA riot together and did some live streaming there, did a little trolling. So I said, yeah, sure, let's do it. I didn't think anyone was going to show up. Because stupid me, I thought, don't these trans people have better things to do with their time than go scream about how Dave Chappelle is ruining their lives?
Like, apparently not.
Seems like a big waste of time. Whatever. We go to Home Depot. You know, I insisted on having good quality signs because I'm turning this into a Married with Children protest. Like, I don't know. You guys remember No Ma'am's protest where Bob Rooney and... the guys would get in a circle and have like the dumbest slogans possible while marching in little circles. Like, all right, I know exactly what this protest is. We go to Home Depot and I get some big fucking poles on these signs, big white. You know, I'm putting my entire half ass into these signs. And we think, okay, it's got to be just so stupid nobody could possibly get upset by it. Like, it's not. It's not we support black comedy, because we don't. I mean, it's like, just comedy's comedy.
You support
I don't,
good comedy, yeah.
Yeah, I support good comedy. I'm not racist about my support of comedy. It's just, we like jokes. Dave is funny. And then Vito goes, well, what about my sign? I'm like, well, we like Dave. Jokes are funny. He goes, jokes are funny. I'm like, yes, it's fucking perfect. Look at our, like, look, now we're matching. See how stupid that is? And people are going to see us going around looking dumb. Like, jokes are funny. And it's going to be like a little bit of levity. I thought maybe even the trans people could embrace it a little bit. Like, oh, you know what? We do like jokes. They do not like jokes. As it turns out. And I mean, obviously, I don't think that those lunatics represent the trans community. Mm-hmm. It's just a bunch of maniacs that, you know, want to bully people, right? Like, that's the trans community doesn't give a fuck. The trans community's out there working and doing whatever. This is just a fringe group of lunatics that had a bad day. So for their entire life. So we get there and it's like, it's popping right away. There's probably 50 protesters, maybe 150 news media reporters and organizations there to cover it.
Outnumbering them 3-1. That's hilarious.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it is big. That was a funny thing about it. There's just so many news people there, like, it's 10 cameras on every single person. Like, oh, is someone going to fuck up? Is someone going to fuck up? Is someone going to fuck up? And then we come in with our fucking signs. And you got all the TERF people there, like women who look like they've been left in the sun for about 30 years, and they've got the entire Bible written on their sign. that they're holding, screaming about how, about whatever. I don't know what their talking points were. But then on the other side, you've got a woman dressed like the Pope and like a guy fatter than Nick Avocado with this little like pink dollop of hair on top of his head. he looks like the Punch Out sequel. Like, he looks like a bad guy from like a Van Damme movie, screaming about rights. And I'm like, oh my god, you guys, like, we're just here joking. Like, I mean you guys are too, but I don't think you know it. So we're arguing with people and having a good time. And we're recording it too, because Vito's going to make a video about it for his YouTube channel. And eventually, Vito said, they pull all the lunatics into the Netflix HQ. All this is at Netflix HQ, mm-hmm. which is the most upsetting to me, because Netflix said, yeah, we absolutely want this. We want this walkout. It's a walkout for Netflix employees to come out and protest their biggest product of the day, and then to attract as many malcontents and psychopaths in the area to come congregate on their property and cause mayhem, and to oversee this potential chaotic moment, they have their two smallest security guards who've borrowed their uncle's suit to show up, like Juan and Paco. They're Juan and Dos in like suits that are going down by their arms, going like, excuse me, sir, can you not stand on the plane? Okay. And they just go back off. Like, this is fucking chaos. So Vito takes his sign. Did you guys see what happened to Vito's sign?
I did see them tear it off. Yeah. Right?
Oh yeah. No, you got to watch that. I did see. That, okay.
Yeah. So they tore off his sign, and then they claimed it was a weapon, right?
Yeah. So Vito has his sign, and then this dude, this guy Joe Cristalli, who's a showrunner for the new Frasier reboot, like the one show that we needed to reboot, Frasier. He comes over and grabs Vito's sign and tears it away from him, or grabs it, pulls it down, smashes his sign, leaving Vito with only the stick. Like, Vito's not a big guy. I mean, he's fat, but he's not, like, muscular. So he's there holding a stick going, oh, you smashed my sign. And the guy goes, he's got a weapon. And then walks away. It's like, bro, was that? It's like, you can't scream he's got a weapon at a trans protest with a bunch of fucking guys, Antifa guys that are, like, mad dogging you and swinging their bike locks like they're in the Warriors, like ready to rumble at any moment. Like, you can't say he's got a weapon. And there's all the cops that are on. Yeah, they're like, all the cops are on bikes in the middle of the street. Like, I know that you know what you're doing, but whatever. So Vito's standing there. If you haven't watched the video, you got to watch it. There's this woman with a tambourine, like, screaming, repent, motherfucker! Repent, motherfucker! Right in his face, and he can't move, because the protesters, they get around you. Like, they stand there, and they put their arms around you like they're hugging a tree, and they're like, I'm not touching you, but if you touch me, then we're going to have a serious problem. And you're like, well, I can't fucking move. Like, I don't know why you think what you're doing is legal, but it's not. Like, it's not like it's like
very
a
mild
Simpson, you know.
Kidnapping.
Yeah. Yeah, like, I can't move. Like, okay, well, I don't know how to get out of this. So I'm like, we're goofing.
Why don't
we're
you
goofing
slink down. Why don't
you... Then like they win, though.
Then he's trying to like juke out of them and like spin to get around.
You just in that situation, you just have to attack that person with everything you have. You
just punch him, right?
Just
and have your life ruined.
I mean, you're already in a pretty good position to like grab him in a body lock and just slam him on their fucking head on the ground, right? Like,
yeah. Like, well, if you fall over, I think they're falling too.
Oh, if Dick does that to someone, 2 seconds until there's articles. Local white supremacist. Oh.
Yeah,
attacked,
house is gone. Everything is gone.
Justice protester at Netflix.
So were you attacked by the?
Yeah. So I thought it would be really funny when they're like smashing Vito's sign and going like, ah, we fucking killed jokes. We fucking killed jokes at this fucking idiot. I thought it'd be so funny to just take my sign and like go behind him. You know, so if anybody's recording it, they would see this awful display, and then see like the Muppets, like a guy going like boop boop, 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 behind with the exact same sign. So I get behind there. I have the video. We played it on my show. I don't know. There's a picture, too. The New York Times has a good picture of me getting shoved, of my head getting shoved into this concrete thing. This guy, the same guy, Joe Crisali, comes over and tries to grab my sign out of the way. Because I'm holding it up. And like they're trying to disguise my sign with their signs, but I got that big old Home Depot stick, so I'm going way like, oh no, I got a fucking 9-foot stick, you idiots! You cannot cover my jokes are funny sign. So Joe comes over and like I'm like this with my sign just standing there, and he kind of comes in and starts twerking on me. Right? Like he slides in and thinks he's being sneaky and grabs my sign and gives it a yank. And I'm like, no, buddy, this is not like you little noodly arm. You're not smashing my sign. I worked hard on this sign for like 10 minutes. I'm not going to, you know, go away. I'm not, you already smashed that guy's sign. You're not smashing my sign. So I hold it. So then he grabs it with both hands. And he's like, I'm trying to take it. And what do you probably know the feeling of a kid trying to rip something out of your hands?
Sure.
Like it's just like you can't stop laughing. It's like, what are you doing? Like, this is my thing. Why are you trying to rip my thing out? So I grab my sign and I go, oh, this guy's trying to take my sign. This guy's trying to, like, I started screaming because it's funny because it's so stupid. I'm like, bro, you're embarrassing yourself. This guy's trying to take my sign. So then I see this fucking little Smurf, this Antifa Smurf guy who looks he's all yoked up. He's a little guy, but he's all yoked, just fucking staring at me, right? Like staring with his blue baklava. And then I realize like, oh, fuck. All right, here we go. So I start screaming, this guy's attacking me. This guy's attacking me. This guy's attacking me. And the next thing I know, Joe pulls me away. So I'm kind of like, I'm still holding my sign the whole time in the video. I have both hands on my sign because I'm not going to. I mean, I'm there with a We Like Fucking Jokes sign. I'm not there to play homoerotic punch up with a bunch of guys who don't have dads, right? So I'm holding this sign, and this fucking guy comes over and takes a running start and shoves me. It's very violent, too, if you watch it. Shoves me against a planter, and then I kind of don't remember the rest, but you can see it on video, then shoves my head into one of those stupid concrete balls that they have in front of Target, you know?
Yeah.
They're like enameled concrete. So I remember I remember the hit. Like, I saw him shoving me, and I thought, well, you know, all right, this is, all right, just try to stay up. And I remember getting hit in a really fucked, like, surprising place. So I thought maybe somebody cranked me with a bike lock or something. Because, like, you're not used to getting hit so hard while you're standing up, right? Like, if you're falling down, you're kind of braced for it. But this was just, like, crack. Like, oh, God, fuck.
Most things that hit in general have some give to them. This has no give. It's a special kind of hard.
Yeah, so you can see it on the video, too. I'm all disoriented and, like, standing up. And trying to figure out who's got the bike lock, because I'm like, all right, well, whoever the bike lock might have a knife or something. So I got to find, like, I'm in danger of being murdered now because these people are just, they're fucking crazy, the people that show up there. And I'm looking around. I'm saying that he hit me in case so someone can record him and get him. And I shit you not, out of nowhere, this little broad appears and says, I know this guy. He's got a rape list. I said,
have raped people you want to rape?
Said, is it? You got to be fucking kidding me. That was Maddox.
Dick.
That was the thing in his video that he did like 7 years ago to get me kicked out of comedy. He said that I ran a rape list because some guys on 4chan made a. They put like Hillary Clinton on a list of women they wanted to rape. And he goes, that's his rape list. And I'm like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. The fucking rape list is coming. I'm gonna get killed because of Maddox's fucking rape list now.
Oh, yeah, you got recognized. Like, oh, yeah, that's the rape list guy. Leave him alone.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that was worse. It was worse that he's got a weapon. Like, he's got a rape list. I'm like, oh no.
But, like, if I'm in that crowd, though, and I hear, that guy's got a rape list, I'm like, the fuck is a rape list?
What does that mean? Is that like a list of conquests? Is it? Does
no,
it?
No
is
one
it
knows.
Plans?
Is that bad?
Does it mean he wants to kill rapists?
I think. I think everyone was so confused that they didn't kick my ass. I don't know. I'm just telling this story straight. Let me know if you want me to pause for a moment and jump in.
No, that's good. That's good. No, that's really funny. So now you have some sort of lawsuit, maybe?
Oh, I hope so. Yeah, I, you know,
do you know,
I found
it?
What's that, Woody?
Were you able to track down the person's identity?
Yes. That's what I was waiting for. That's what took me so long to file the police report, because I didn't want to go to the police and say, yeah, a little angry blue guy, attacked me and I don't know anything. So this dude hit me up after the fact. With all kinds of footage from the day, saying of the guy who hit me confessing to like this trans woman live streamer, what he did, and like then he's talking to he's him
what
and
a
this
dumbass.
Yeah, this dude I'm not gonna say because I don't want your channel to get fucked with. But it's on my channel. He's talking to this live streamer, Precious Child is her name. That's not unknown. Yeah. He's talking to her about him doing it, and then she's like, "Well, do you want to trade clothes so that you can go back so to avoid detection?" He goes, "Oh yeah, I don't want them getting my identity." So sure as shit, the cops get there. The dude comes back in the black mask instead of his blue outfit, and then the same guy who sent me the thing found him on interviews and other places and like triangulated, you know, this is the guy. He isolated his laugh during the interviews and like played it back and like this. He got different angles of the shape of his skull and his face. the guy's like a CrossFit gym owner and a Olympic weightlifter and like a college football player. I was like, oh, amazing. Okay. So they found the one Antifa who works out to sick on me. And then it turns out the fucking guy who found it all was a rooftop Korean. So in the 90s, you remember those guys?
Yeah, smoking cigarette and mustache.
That was his dad. Was the rooftop Korean in the 90s? He was 18. He was going around to all the ghetto neighborhoods, fucking flashing his piece, so the gangs there knew not to fuck with the rooftop Koreans. Like that was they had a whole squad of guys. The guys who were not on the roof were driving around, fucking enforcing or whatever, trying to intimidate the gangs from fucking with their stores. Cool dude.
Jeez.
Yeah,
that
anyway.
That is an insane tale. And you just wanted to carry a sign that said, Dave is funny, jokes are funny.
Yeah.
We like jokes.
And
I like jokes.
You might have a lifetime of like, not, I mean, forget the physical trauma, but the mental trauma that you've been through. I'm sure you've had nightmares. I'm sure that like maybe you don't feel safe in your own home at times and you're in public. Like it's got to be hard.
I bet it's even.
I don't want to judge, but I think your back and neck hurt.
Yeah. No. I know, no joke.
I got a stress headache just by hearing your story. I'm wondering if maybe there's a class action suit.
Yeah.
I'm upset by hearing that from Kyle, so I'd like to sign.
Yeah, the class action of everyone who likes jokes can sign up to my class action lawsuit. My brain didn't work for. I mean, it's like one of those things where I know it was fucked. The next day, I forgot full-on conversations that I had that night. I don't really remember the impact. I was doing, I was leaving half coffee around the house getting made, and it got better. But then I start wondering, am I getting used to the forgetfulness? Like, I don't really know. Mm-hmm. You know, like, the fear of it is, am I getting asymptotically better and it never gets better? Because mm-hmm. that's really... That is really bothering me and pissing me off. The nature of head injuries are, I don't have any words anymore to describe these things because I'm retarded.
Because
now.
Of the head injury, perhaps.
Because of the head injury. But it's
you
very
were much
scary.
Funnier before this.
Thank you. Thank you for saying that.
You were smarter also.
Yeah.
You used to be able to carry a show. I was happy when I heard you came on. Now that I see what we've gotten.
I'm a little worried.
Now he's all busted up.
I'm all messed up now.
I'm wondering if we at PKA could seek some sort of financial restitution because we didn't know what we were getting ourselves into.
Yeah. Yeah.
We didn't know this man was damaged goods after that neo-Nazi attacked him. We didn't know.
The neo-Nazi.
You're not going to sell as much of your goo juice because I can't keep a conversation going. I know. Everyone suffers.
Dude, that is afterwards, such a fucking insane situation.
Yeah, afterwards.
Yeah, terrible.
Yeah. When Vito and I left, we hadn't checked our phones all day. Because if you take your phone out at one of these things, some fucking idiot's going to slap it out of your hand. And I'm like, oh, well, there's $1,200. Thanks, bud. But when we got our phones back on in the car, which they chased us down to a car. Fucking Antifa chased us down to a car. And,
jeez. Yeah, they cannot take a joke.
Dude, that's one thing I learned about trans women from this experience is they really don't like jokes. when we checked our phones, it was blowing up. Like the clips of him getting his sign smashed already had like a million views on it. It was crazy. It was really crazy.